Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Madonna Bloodline Art, helping you with drawing ideas. Thank you to my 350 subscribers. I'm glad you're here. If you're new here to my channel, please subscribe so you don't miss any videos in the future. So today I'm going to show you another series of sea creatures. Thank you to Colors of Roshika and Nino Art Life for suggesting me to draw more sea creatures. So today I decided to use a bristle paper instead of sketchbook and a micro pen 05 to draw directly. So for this series I will draw mostly different kinds of fish. I'm going to call it as a school of fish. This is a simple drawing challenge. I'm curious how many fish I can draw in this 9x12 paper. So sea animals are very interesting to draw because they come with different sizes, shapes, and textures. But for this challenge, I opt for line art style as I only have 1 hour. Yes, I put myself a timer to draw on this particular series. Yes, that's right. I try to be realistic as possible. So there are times that it is hard to pull off the time to paint or draw, but you can do what you can draw for the moment and be realistic with the subject that you choose. And I set myself a challenge because I know it will be helpful for the skills along the way. So today I'm going to talk to you also on tips for finding inspiration for your art, which sometimes it can be hard to be inspired to create something. And when I can't find anything that inspired me, I made myself a challenge. Yes, challenge is really great for honing your skills or just being creative with the time that is available to you for the moment. And I'm going to give you tips also on how to be inspired. So let's get started. So the first one is unplug yourself from social media once in a while. So whether you are an engaging artist, hobbyist, or creative, chances are you have sometimes uninspired because instead of making your own art for the moment, you keep on scrolling other people's art, and it can be paralyzing and it can result also to art blocks. So social media can be very time consuming and can greatly affect your creative habit and mentality. And I do believe that some of the best stuff happens offline, and it's hard to be inspired when you're constantly looking at how many likes or comments you should get instead of allowing yourself to grow in your art or finding your own style. For the next one is limit your art supplies. Remember the time when you were just starting with just how many art supplies that you just in hand, you will feel more inspired to draw, sketch, or paint rather than hoarding or buying as many as you want and turning your art space into an art store instead. So it is best to get rid of the stuff that you really don't need for painting, drawing, or sketching. You don't need a lot to start. You don't need a lot of supplies to be creative. Having this in mind, it will be worth it along the way. So for the third one is nature walk. Nature walk has a lot to offer, from just going to a garden, even walking around the house. The inspiration is never ending. I look around, feel, smell, open up your senses. It's definitely free resource for everyone. Bathe yourself with things that inspired you. Nature is very amazing. Just allow yourself to discover. Realize that inspiration exists, but it has to find you working. For the four tips is listen to motivational talks. So this is very important too, because sometimes you need other people to kick your butt, also get going. And either if you have art blocks or just in a state of frustration, listening to positive and encouraging words is very uplifting. So for the next tip is find inspiration from your own feelings and imagination. Imagination is another way to be creative, and this is personal but a very powerful asset in terms of your creative freedom and creative side. Paint, draw your emotions. Sometimes you don't have to always rely on references. Use your imagination, and the sky is the limit. Sometimes feelings can be trapped, but you can use it as your inspirations too, by expressing your own feelings through your drawing, painting, how you feel. You'll be able to release or apply it there in your own art. So for number six is be kind to yourself and allow to have fun. Now this is something that is really important too. Make a mess, play like a kid. You will be surprised that playtime can be resolved into massive new discoveries and happy accidents. Welcome failure, and it's part of being creative. Try not to be super serious. Have fun and don't lose your inner child. Make mistakes and make lots of them. For the number seven is read art books and keep them. Art books are great resources because if you can't find great inspiration for your art around you, you can use this for your techniques or methods that you can apply if you don't feel inspired. If you have art blocks, I have separate videos for that. You can check it out if you have a hard time also gathering creative ideas for your drawing or sketching. If you don't feel like drawing or painting, read instead. This is super helpful. And if you don't have physical book, read ebooks instead. That will do also. And for number eight, sketchbooks. Sketchbooks are amazing tools that you can just pour yourself there. They are a safe place for your weakness and strength. You can see your improvements and milestones and celebrate them, recognize it, and keep it. And also comparing your adventure when you were just starting, it can be really inspiring because you can see your journey along the way. So cheer up, keep going. For number nine is make a list of things that inspire you. Put it somewhere where you will see it every day, either in your desk or wall. And you can even use notepads or even save it to your phone. So the last one is find inspiration from people or from your travel. So if it's hard for you to find inspiration within your inner feelings or imagination, you can pull them from people that you know or people around you. Observe and it will be there. I do believe that the more you learn, the more you see. So keep learning. Inspirations are everywhere. So there you go, guys. I hope I inspired you today. Those are my 10 tips for finding your inspiration for your art. Thank you for watching and supporting my channel. You can support me also through my Ko-fi page. I have the link in my description below. So please subscribe for more drawing tips, ideas, and inspirations. Now I'm done with this fish drawing. And keep drawing, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.